We got taught that Aboriginal people were sort of nomadic and lived off the land, and you know, but we actually had irrigation systems, houses, you know, we had civilizations of 10,000 people, and not to mention the world's first fish traps. So they're 65,000 years old, and that stuff should be celebrated because it's not just Indigenous history, it's Australia's history, and it's part of us all. I want to tell our story and, you know, help kids find science.
How big is the star? How many stars are in the sky?
Why does star blink?
Morning, Corey. How are you this morning?
Good. I got another parcel for you.
Oh, that's good. You're doing well. You've been posted a few. Good job.
Kids in remote areas, they deserve the best resources and the latest resources to, you know, grow their minds. And I was just like, you know what? I've got to do more. So I Googled most remote school in Australia. And then I found a school with 15 books in it. So I packed up every single book I owned and I sent it to the school. My name's Corey Tutt and I'm founder of Deadly Science.
Corey first mentioned Deadly Science to me, I think it was a few years ago. We're sitting in a pub and he's telling me about this great idea he has for introducing science programs to Aboriginal communities. I just thought, wouldn't that be cool if that could actually happen?
In high school, it was, you know, stick to a trade. You're not going to go to university, you're not going to finish school. To be a zookeeper, which is what I wanted to do, you had to have a degree in zoology, and you had to tick every box, and, you know, only the smart kids get to do that. It's hard when you get told that enough that, you know, the head noise sort of gets there and you start to believe that. So around that time, probably my grades started to slip quite a bit and I started to be a bit disengaged with school. When I left school, I needed a change and I really desperately wanted to work with animals. And I came across this Facebook page for a wildlife sanctuary and it was in Western Australia. I sort of packed up my things and saved up some money and I went over there.
I think Corey, he's had a tough life and he's probably seen a lot of bad stuff, but he's someone who persevered through that and become a role model.
When I was 18 at the zoo, unfortunately one of my close friends had passed away. He had committed suicide. It didn't feel real. I kind of felt like, you know, sort of the floorboards had been taken from under me and I was kind of falling. And I would go to the zoo and I'd look at animals that once brought a smile to my face and it just didn't feel right. Eventually I decided that it was time to leave zookeeping. I was completely lost when I started alpaca shearing. I had just lost my friend to suicide and I needed the time away and the time to see Australia and sort of grow as well. I learned a lot about myself. Literally the first alpaca that we sheared together headbutted me in the face and cracked my cheekbone. And it was, I had this big shiner of a black eye for, it felt like weeks.
Don't get annoyed. You're mouthful. There you go.
I met Corey about 6 months ago. He started talking about this sort of side project that he had.
So I started financing the books by working a second job.
The most extraordinary thing about that was how much it's grown, because when he started it, my concern about it was scale up. He's proved me wrong.
We've sent books to over 52 schools now, and we've got another 30 on the waiting list. And Marianne was, you know, she was the original person that sort of believed that I could do something.
So I started by going through the books that we had at home. And now it's like whenever I go past a bookshop, I'll go in and see if there's something.
That's probably for an individual kid.
Oh, wow.
To do a whole lot of little experiments and so I think that'd be a fun thing.
Marianne's donated countless books, hours, and just so much time to Deadly Science.
My mum was a children's librarian and my dad was a scientist. So the combination of those two things make it very personal for me.
I think some of the best questions I've ever heard have come from kids from the bush.
The old people here said the bush tuckameat is fat and ready when the moon is full. Why is this?
So we got little Adam's question about the meat tasting better during the full moon. So I cannot find a scientist that can answer it, But I've got a theory. You know, we started Skyping the kids in the classrooms because I wanted them to put a face to the books. I wanted them to know where they come from and know my story as well.
I don't think I've ever met anybody quite like Corey. The passion that he has, his ability to really put himself out there, to work two jobs, to not take no for an answer, to be like super empathic. And he's really built from scratch something that is pretty incredible.
We're just so excited to, you know, be part of Deadly Science, and we can't wait to see what the future brings, so thank you.
And I really think it's good for him to go out and show other kids that no matter how your life starts, you can make your life something amazing and, you know, full of science.
Hey there, my name is Mark Fennell, and if you enjoyed that, and I'm hoping that you did, then make sure you like and subscribe to the Feed's YouTube channel, and definitely watch that thing that I have absolutely seen before. It's really good.